We turn now to Jeff Merchant, candidate for chair for the Utah Democratic Party. Jeff, great to have you on the show. Thanks so much for being here.
Yeah, thanks, Glenn.
Let's get into your background. What is it that you've done throughout your life that you feel qualifies you for this position?
So I think there are a number of things. First and foremost, I am a lifelong Utahn. I am a Democrat, and I have been a Democrat since the time I was old enough to vote, and that's something that I think is really important. Having said that, I think that my background and experience as an attorney and as a businessman really are what the party needs right now in order to move forward.
Obviously, this is an important position within the party. It takes a lot of work. As you looked at it and made the decision, what was it that said, yeah, I want to make a push for this?
So as a delegate and someone who's been involved in the Democratic Party for a long time, the biggest concerns that I have and a lot of other people in the Democratic Party in Utah have are the debt situation that we have, the lack of quality staffing, and the lack of support for candidates. I think those are all things that I have experience in, and particularly my background as someone who fixes businesses that have kind of fallen apart financially and in terms of staffing and all of that. Those are all things I think I can bring to the table and help the party with.
So what would you do to do those things?
Okay, well, first and foremost, I think that the problem with the party right now is that we don't have a plan. And any organization that wants to be successful has to have some kind of a plan in moving forward. So the first thing that I would do, and the first thing anyone, whoever wins this position, is going to have to do is focus on fundraising. We're about $80,000 in debt. We've managed to pay a little bit of that off, but right now we still have $41,000-$42,000 on a credit card, which is not a good thing. But, you know, my background has given me the opportunity to be okay with debt and to work through those problems. I'm not intimidated by that. I'm not concerned about going out and raising money, which in my mind is not rocket science, but it is about asking, and it is about asking the right people.
We've seen not only in the Utah Democratic Party, but other parties as well, this division between, you know, a progressive arm of the party and a more moderate one. If you were to be elected chair, how would you come in and try to bring those two sides together?
Yeah, so
and it could even be more than that.
Yeah, well, look, I think that like any organization, there are people with different perspectives and different views. That is not an exception for the Democratic Party here in Utah. But if you look at the type of people that have supported me in this candidacy, they come from both sides of that division. And what my hope is that we can bring those people together by having conversation and communication, which is something that hasn't been happening over the last several years.
Do you see that as part of the fundraising problem, is that maybe some from either of those different sides have become disenfranchised and stopped wanting to give money to the party?
Oh yeah. I think that there is a tremendous lack of trust right now with how the party is how the party is a steward of money. And I think that a lot of people are very concerned about donating both on the progressive side and the more moderate side. But let's be honest, I mean, I think that if people see the party succeeding and people see the party doing better, then they're gonna be more inclined to donate money.
If you are elected, where do you see the party 2 years from now?
I see in 2 years from now, obviously 2020 is a vital election, I think, for the entire country, particularly here in Utah. I see a lot of success. And in fact, I see over the next 5-10 years, substantial success for Democrats. This is a state that's turning blue. If you look at the Republican chair race, there was a lot of talk. They're very concerned about the demographic changes and the efforts the Democrats are making, both here in Utah and nationally. And I think that we're going to see the state turning over the next several years.
Talk about electability and the party's role in getting candidates and helping them take office. Back in November was really a good night for Utah Democrats, specifically in Salt Lake County. But when you shift your focus to statewide, it's been decades since a Democrat has won a statewide election. What is your plan to try to turn that around?
Yeah, so I think that one of the things that we have to be able to do as Democrats is remember that we're a big tent party. We accept people from lots of different perspectives, lots of different viewpoints, and the viewpoints that work in a place like Salt Lake City may not work in a place like Price and may not work in a place like Ogden. You know, if we look at places like Carbon County, we look at places like Weber County, even parts of Utah County, which, you know, everybody always wants to blow off as totally conservative, we have opportunities to grow in those communities. And they grow because we focus on them and we give them some of the resources they need in order to succeed.
Do you feel like the party has gotten away from that big tent mentality?
I think that we have a little bit. I think that we have failed to remember that just because we don't agree on specific policies all the time, that we still agree on values. And as democratic values, I say this all the time, democratic values are Utah values. They're very, very similar. And we have to remember that as we focus on those things, that we can have success, even if we don't agree on how to implement certain policies or even bigger concepts that the legislature might work on.
Okay, Jeff, appreciate your time. It goes by very quick, but glad to have you with us on this Sunday morning. Thanks for
being here. Absolutely.